Dear viewers of the Tom Photo channel, I once made a video where I compared Kdenlive and DaVinci Resolve, the link is below, and decided that out of the two wonderful tools, I'll continue with Kdenlive. Now I'd like to make a very basic introductory course of Kdenlive to get you started very quickly. I'm not going to explain all options, but I will only talk about what matters the most to conserve time. More detailed tutorials will follow. My Kdenlive is for Linux, but it will work equally well on Windows or Mac. The appearance of your GUI may be different, but it will be different anyway because you can customize it. There are logging, editing, audio, effects, and color tabs. We are only worrying about the editing tab today. Under editing, the most important settings are, first, the box where you put your video, image, and sound files, all nicely together. Secondly, the area where you do your editing, and then the box where you see your video. Let's drag a few video, image, and sound files into the storage box. As you do this, Kdenlive is recognizing the format of the first video file and is offering your project settings based on this. Accept it or change the settings later. To do this, go to Project and Project Settings. Let's make sure that our video is going to be full HD and 29.97 frames per second. This is the most typical setting. Note that you can make subfolders if you want to separate different types of files or organize your files better. Let's start editing our video. Drag the video files you want into the editing area. In the bottom corner, there is a slider that lets you zoom in and out. The vertical white line is the playhead. Move it to a specific part of your video. If you want to play your video from a specific location, set the playhead and press the triangular play button under the video. Note that your video file consists of two parts, the video part and the audio part, and they are linked. For this tutorial, we don't want the native sound, so we remove it. Right-click on your clip and select Ungroup Clips. Now the two parts become separate, and you don't affect one if you modify the other. We are right-clicking on the audio part and selecting Delete Selected Item. Let's, for the fun of it, cut our video in half using the small scissors icon and then clicking with it anywhere in the video. If you want to do precision cutting, first zoom in, then place your playhead where you want to cut, then place the scissors on top of the playhead until the playhead turns red, and then cut. Select the arrow again to move out of the scissor function. We are now free to move the two clips independently and can change their order, for example. If you grab a beginning or end with your mouse, you can shrink the video from that end, and this is always reversible. We can also bring in more clips from the storage area anytime we want. Let's do that. Remove the sound from the new clip as well and continue with three clips. Did you notice that we have two tracks for video and two for audio? You need this when you want to overlay two clips. If you want more tracks, you can right-click on the left of the editing area and choose more video or audio tracks as you wish. Let me make an additional video track. Now we can put all of our clips on separate tracks if we need this for further editing for some reason. At this point, it makes sense to save the current state of the project by selecting File and Save. This will make a .kdenlive file that you can load any time to continue your work from the point where you previously left off. But back to our example. Here's a very basic example of clip transition that you see a lot, the wipe. Simply move one clip over another and click on their overlapping area to get a blue box. When I play this region of the video back to you, you'll see how one clip becomes another. A very common transition is fade in and fade out. When you go to the top corner of your clip, you see a red dot appear. Drag it toward the center of the clip to get fade in and fade out. I'll do it for the two neighboring clips here. This is the playback to show you how it looks in the end. In the upper left is the project box where your clips are. On my computer and with my current Kdenlive settings, it consists of several tabs, and I can switch it to Effects tab. This is the list of effects you can apply, and the list is searchable too. Let's assume we want to make our clip darker. I'm going to type brightness in the search and I'll get two options, brightness and brightness keyframeable. Keyframeable means that you can select different values for different frame regions of a clip as opposed to the entire clip. I like keyframeable, so I drag the keyframeable option on top of the clip with my mouse. The box to the right of the video now populates with the fields where I can now select brightness values. If I now set the value to 50, the entire clip gets uniformly 2 times darker. But I want to stay at the current value and make it darker gradually. So I double click on the clip to get a new blue dot. Drag it along the clip to the location and value that you like. You can do it again to add another value, like so. Let me show you now how the clip gets gradually darker in the middle. There are countless of other effect options, but I will save them for my future and more advanced videos. Let me right click on the video clip again. This will show you many options. I'm guessing the change speed will interest you. You can set a new playback speed for your video, speed it up or slow it down by changing the percent value. We can slow down a video with a smooth result only if our recording speed was faster than the 30 frames per second of our current project. Otherwise, the video will get jumpy because the missing frames will have to be interpolated. Speeding up is easier because it will just cause the video to delete some frames. Still, it makes sense to speed up the video an integer number of times so that the frames are dropped evenly. 200% will delete every other frame and the video remains smooth. 400% will retain every fourth frame. But for example, 165% will cause the frames to be dropped unevenly, so this is not recommended. More about that in my upcoming videos. The tick box that says reverse clip will reverse the clip, and this can be a lot of fun. Here's the video playing from end to beginning. But what about using photos? No problem. You can use a photo as a static video clip. Drag it into the video track and expand it with your mouse to as long as you want. If your image is a PNG file with a transparent background, you can add something on top of your video. It could be a drawing or text or whatever. In my case, it is text, so I can now show some text over the video. Let me play this region of video to you now to show how the text appears over the video. Other methods of showing text will be in my future videos. We previously removed the audio. Let's bring in new audio now. This is a music file. Drag it from the file box to the editing window right under the video clips. You can manipulate the audio files the same way as the video files. Move, shrink, cut, etc. Why don't we decrease the volume as an example? For this, we go to Effects tab and type Volume in the search box. Now drag the volume keyframeable on top of the audio clip. You see a similar window on the right as we saw in the brightness example. Exactly the same as before, you double click on the audio clip to change the volume of any part of the clip. In my today's example, I'm making the sound fade away at the end. This is the result. Listen. Now we have a nice edited video with transitions and background music. Let's turn this into a video file. This is called rendering. Go to Project and Render. 3 things matter the most here. In the left, you select the main rendering settings. For a normal HD video, I'd select Generic and then MP4H264/AAC. This works the best for the internet. On the right is Custom Quality. This lets you select quality versus file size. Here, 75% will get you a reasonable quality with a relatively small file size. The last slider is encoder speed. The slower it is, the better the outcome, but the longer it takes to get the job done. I'd recommend to select slow here. Now press render to file and wait. For us, it goes very fast, but it can take hours with long 4K videos. You can watch it run or you can close the Kdenlive window and let it run in the background. This is the final product that we made. I'd like to thank you for watching and ask you to subscribe to my channel and leave a like under the video if you feel like it. Have a wonderful day. See you soon.